and welcome to another segment of Chat with Nat. Today we are talking to Captain of the Firebirds, the dirtiest player in the league, apparently, Lauren Nurse. How are you going, Loz?
I'm good, thank you. Love that tag, Nat. It's only going to stick around, isn't it?
It is. You're filthy, absolutely filthy. Now it's a Friday, last day of school for the week. How are the kids?
Plus the rain, it's definitely a Friday. You can feel it's a Friday.
Let's talk about the season and a bit of the netball. We're 3 from 3. Is that a bit easier than this year being captaining a winning side rather than a bunch of losers?
Easier and a whole lot nicer. But you know as well as I do, it's only a start. So 3 games in and 3 wins is great, but we need to be able to keep that going.
As I mentioned at the start, you've been tagged as the filthiest player by a certain somebody. Now, coming from you, who do you think is actually should be crowned the filthiest player in the competition?
Oh, I think everybody could really claim that title at some stage or another. You know, Nat, you love to drop the shoulder like no one else I've ever seen before. Amy Steele's renowned for her elbows and her grubbing, and you know, Laura Gotts, she's just game on behind the play, so, you know.
You're naming all your teammates. outside
the square, probably Kim Green. Yeah, she is a good coach.
Yeah. She likes to get in there.
But I wouldn't label just one person. I mean, most people on their day.
Start a blacklist.
Blacklist instead of blacklist.
2 years ago, at the Netball Australia dinner, you struggled to find one word to describe the national coach, Norma Plummer. Have you yet been able to find a word to describe her?
I think that after all that, I think I ended up with blunt, and I'm going to stick with blunt.
Blunt? So it's 2 years?
Yeah, maybe things have gotten even blunter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, maybe.
You know, as she's getting older.
Norma's fantastic, but she tells it like it is.
Yeah.
So I'll go with blunt.
You got to like similar that. Similar to me, you are a South Australian, and we've actually had this conversation before how we probably fail quite a bit in the swimming. The swimming department.
Keep the Queenslander in the pool. It's not us.
Oh no, it's not us. We're absolutely useless. Now, you, from all reports, are starting to becoming a bit friendlier with the beach and everything in the last few months. Anything behind that?
No, I like the beach. I'm working on a real tan.
That's it.
Yeah, staying afloat.
Now, netballer, is there any other sports that tickle your fancy?
Tickle my fancy. Love horse riding. Love it. Love to get back into that.
Love to get into the saddle.
Yeah. I'd say I'd like to take up triathlons when I finish playing netball,
really?
But clearly need to work on the swimming aspect a little bit.
You can maybe get someone else to.
Yeah,
to
maybe the team of it. Yeah.
Team event. What about tennis?
Tennis. tennis.
This Sunday afternoon at the Brisbane Convention Centre, who do we need to look out for the opposition?
Probably Danica Whippy-Edy, their girl shitter is a bit of a target.
How do you say that surname?
Whippy-Edy? I'm not going to say Danica, we'll run with Danica. She's a bit of a target for them. And then obviously their defenders in Liana De Bruin. Ask Rose how to say that one. And Selby Rickett. They're a strong team. We just need to focus on what we need to do, I'm not too worried.
My usual last question that I always finish with, and do not say straight. Describe Rose for me in one word.
I'm gonna go with knowledgeable.
And why?
Well, I just think the first 3 games of the season, I think that the Firebirds have been better prepared than ever for each of our games, and we've really talked about and analysed the other team, and that's due to Rose's good work, so I'm going to say knowledgeable.
Thank you very much for letting me come to your school and having a chat.
Anytime, you can come and play with the kids anytime you like.
Brilliant. I'll be stalking around outside of the school. Well, thanks for having a chat, and we will see you next week with another segment.